Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss caliper lock.
So if simply I ask you what is the meaning of caliper, okay, that means it is, let us suppose there is a device. So it's a device that measures the thickness of the two surfaces, thickness between the two surfaces in a very precise way. Okay, basically it takes the small measurements. So that is what the objective of the caliper, that is what the meaning of caliper. Okay, so what is the main purpose of caliper logging? It's basically the tool here measure the borehole diameter. Okay, the tool here measure the borehole diameter, and some of the tools also measure the shape of the borehole. Okay, we will see that later. So the caliper log is a tool for measuring the diameter and shape of the borehole. Okay, this is the basic thing. Abhi, the tool can be of two arms or four arms. Tool is tarike se design ho sakte hain ki wo two arm tool ho sakte hain, four arm tool ho sakte hain. In general, the two arm tools are used only for the diameter of the borehole. Okay, so this is how a caliper tool look likes. Okay, see. This is simple two arm caliper device. Clear? So the simple mechanical caliper measures a vertical profile of the diameter, basically where the diameter is increasing or decreasing. Basically we see the variation of diameter with depth in the caliper lock. Okay, so in the two arm tool, the borehole diameter is measured, and this is shown in the track 1 of the master log together with the bit size. And what is this bit size? Whatever the drill bit we are using, it has some size, it has some diameter. Okay, and that diameter is fixed. What is changing? It is the diameter of borehole that is changing. The drill bit size is fixed, the diameter of the borehole is changing. It can increase or decrease. Okay, so that we will see later in the figure, then it will be very clear. The arms are linked to the cursor of a potentiometer. Okay, and so basically this is was the case of two arm tool. If we talk about four arm tool, basically dual caliper tool, also you can say that the two opposite pair work together to give the borehole diameter in the two perpendicular directions. Okay, just remember things, that is not going to ask you in an examination, but just know it for borehole geometry tool. Okay, and this tool also calculates volume of the borehole, and it has a sensor basically that measures the direction or azimuth of the hole deviation. And third is the deep of the borehole. So the four arm logging tool of caliper has more applications. It just not measure the borehole diameter, it is also measures the borehole volume, deep of the hole is also measured. Okay, clear? So the four arms coupled in the pairs, each opening to a maximum hole diameter of 30 inches. The mechanical caliper measures variation in the borehole diameter with depth, as I have told you. So how this diameter is changing, where it diameter depends? Okay, there are some factors. The diameter of the hole depends mainly on the lithology. Okay, what kind of lithology it is? Okay, what kind of lithology it is? Since certain rocks can be soluble, okay, since certain rocks may be soluble in the drilling mud and disintegrate and cave in. There are certain rocks which may be soluble in the drilling mud, and there are some rock which disintegrate and cave in, in which case the whole caves will appear. We will see in this figure. Just write, know what are the things it depends on. Flow, as in the case of swelling shales, and be consolidated, the hole will be in engorged condition. All things will be clear when I will show you the figure. Okay, do not get confused. So all these things are
these are the factors which are affecting the diameter of the borehole. And this caliper device, as I've told you, we do not measure things separately. This caliper tool is attached with other devices. For example, we are measuring, we are going for logging, other logging tools like basically the logging tools are automatically equipped with a caliper, such as micro logs, density neutron tools, okay, where the caliper arm is used to apply the measuring head of the tool to the borehole wall. Where the caliper arm is used to apply the measuring head of the tool to the borehole wall. Okay. Let me show you a picture how the arms look. Okay. See in this picture. So this is the formation. And this is how caliper tool looks. Okay. This is a two arm tool. So the measurement are made by the two arms pushed against the borehole wall. You can see in this picture. Okay. And the arms are linked to the cursor of a variable resistance. Okay. These arms are linked to a cursor of variable resistance. And the lateral movement of arms is translated into the movements of the cursor along the resistance and hence variation in the electrical output. This is basically how we see the variation in the diameter. So basically what happens, let me repeat, the lateral movement of the arms, the lateral movements of the arms is translated into the movements of cursor along the resistance and hence variation in the electrical output. The variation in the output are translated into a diameter variation after a simple calibration. Okay, clear hai? Now there is one term which is calibration. You will heard this term in upcoming videos also, and anyone can ask you what is calibration in logging. So what is calibration? Basically we will talk about this so much in the gamma ray log, but right now just know what is calibration. Basically to adjust a value to some standard value, okay, that is what we do in calibration. Basically to adjust whatever we are getting to some standard value which we get in the standard environment. It is the way in which whatever we are measuring the logging tool, what we are measuring from the logging tool, so that this measurement are adjusted to some standard value. Okay, right now I will just give you the basic idea of calibration, otherwise we will discuss in detail in the gamma ray log. So that is how a two arm tool look. Okay, this is a caliper tool showing the conversion of a mechanical moment to an electrical signal using a variable resistance. Okay, so I've already discussed how the diameter of hole depends on these things. Now let's move forward. There is also other things, the texture and structure of rock. Okay, this also influences the diameter. This influences the porosity and permeability of the rock and hence determine whether a mud cake will develop and its thickness, leading to the course of a reduced hole diameter. Okay, so what it's saying, basically if the rock is porous and permeable, then it is only possible that the mud cake will build up. Okay, I've already told you in vision. If you have not seen that video, please go and watch that video where I have discussed the invasion process. So if there is porous and permeable bed, then only a mud cake can build up. Okay, and when a mud cake is built up, what will happen? When a mud cake is built up, then the diameter will be reduced. Okay, can you imagine? I will show the figure, then you will have a clear understanding. But right now try to imagine, if the mud cake is built up, the diameter will be reduced. It is quite obvious. Okay, that is what it is saying. So
Frequently, logging tools are automatically equipped with a caliper such as MicroLogs and density neutron tools. As I have told you, we do not just like measuring only diameter. We are going into the well and only measuring diameter. That is not happening. The tool is attached. We use combination of tools. Okay. Simultaneously we use the combination of tools, and in one tool is also there always there a caliper tool which measures the diameter of the borehole, because it gives the useful data which is going to be used in other applications also. Okay, clear? So how log is presented? I have already told you, the caliper log is plotted in the track 1 with the drilling bit size for comparison. Okay, drilling bit size is fixed, as I said, and what varies is the diameter of the borehole. So we always in the track we always put the drilling bit size and compare it with the borehole diameter, whether the borehole diameter is decreasing or increasing. We compare it with the drill bit size. Okay, or as a differential caliper reading represents the caliper value, drill bit size, diameter. Caliper value minus drill bit size diameter. Okay, differential caliper reading is also there. So these things are clear to you, I hope. So what happens in a 4-ohm basically dual caliper tool? The data from the caliper pairs are shown together and they are different, indicating an oval hole. Okay, there are dual caliper log, and if the data which is obtained from caliper pairs are shown together and we found that the data is different, that means it's indicate an oval hole. That means it's indicate an oval hole. Basically, it's talking about the shape of the borehole. We will see this, okay? We will see this. Right now, I'm just giving you an idea. We will see all those things. Now, see this figure. This is borehole geometry log. Basically, in this figure, I am showing you the 4-arm caliper tool. It measures the hole deviation, it measures the hole azimuth, and it's also measures the diameter of the borehole. Okay. You can see in this figure that you can see the variation of readings. Like there is written caliper 1-3, calipers 2-4. What are these things? Let me give you an idea of 4-arm caliper device. The borehole geometry log is basically showing the 4-arm caliper device. Okay, it's a 4-arm caliper device. So how it works? See, what happens? Let us suppose this is the cross section of 4-arm caliper device. Okay, let us suppose this. So here one pair represents, let us suppose it is 1 and it is 3 and it is 2 and it is 4. So what happens? Basically, this is the cross section. So you are seeing this in figure, the calipers 1-3, this represent one pair, and the calipers 2-4, this also represent one pair. We are talking about 4-arm caliper device, which is also called dual caliper device. In that, the two arms in the 4-arm caliper device are in pair. 1-3 is in one pair, 2-4 is in one pair. Now what happens when this device takes reading? What will happen? 1-3 pair can give something other reading, and 2-4 pair can also give some other reading. For example, you can see in this figure, this one represents calipers 1-3. Okay, this one represent caliper 1-3. That means the reading it is showing is from 1-3 pair, and this one represents 2-4. This one represents 2-4. So you can see these both readings are different, and this line, this one particularly shows 2-4. Okay, 2-4 pair. So you can see in this figure, these both readings are different. Any condition in borehole can come. We will see this later in detail when we talk about the interpretation of 4-arm caliper device. Right now, I am giving you the basic idea.
So anytime what will happen, this reading of 2-4 or 1-3 can be different, can be same. Okay, ऐसा हो सकता है कि एक रीडिंग दूसरे से ज़्यादा हो, या दोनों ज़्यादा हो ड्रिल बिट साइज से, या एक कम हो एक ज़्यादा हो, या बराबर हो. We will see all these conditions. So right now I am giving you the basic idea how a caliper, four arm caliper device works. So there are two arms in one pair, two arms in one pair. 1-3 represent one arm, 2-4 represent one arm. Okay, that things must be clear to you. You can see this caliper 1-3 represents one arm pair, caliper 2-4 represent one arm pair. Okay, and these readings, basically with the reading we are getting from this pair can be different, and the readings we are getting from these pairs can be different, can be same, can be greater or lesser from the drill bit size. Okay, so this is what it is, the basic idea of four arm caliper device or borehole geometry lock. और ये जो हमने क्रॉस सेक्शन की बात की थी, ये एक चीज़ और जान लो यहाँ पे, ये जो कैलिपर्स हैं 1-3 ये 11 इंचेस हैं, और कैलिपर्स 2-4 9 इंचेस है. मतलब एक कैलिपर है जो कह सकते हो लार्ज है और एक है स्मॉल है. ओके, और ये दोनों कैलिपर्स एक दूसरे के परपेंडिकुलर हैं. ये जो मैंने क्रॉस सेक्शन ड्रॉ किया था ऐसे, ये जो मैंने दिखाया था तुम्हें कि एक 1-3 है एक 2-4 है, ये क्रॉस सेक्शन ड्रा करने का मतलब यही था कि बोथ दिस पेयर आर परपेंडिकुलर, वन इज स्मॉल एंड अदर इज लार्ज. जैसे कि तुम देख रहे हो एक 11 इंचेस है और एक 9 इंचेस है. ओके, सो इतनी बात भी पता होनी चाहिए. शुरू में जिसने ध्यान दिया होगा मैंने वहाँ भी बताया था कि बोथ द पेयर्स आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर. ओके, क्लियर. Here you can see at this part the reading is quite similar, and can you think what would be the condition of borehole when the both arms of basically both pairs of the caliper device is giving the same reading? Can you guess? So that is what it is. So as I've said, the four arm caliper tool has better applications, like it gives us about the volume of the borehole also. So what we get from it? So what we get from the volume of the borehole? With the help of the borehole volume, we estimate the amount of drilling mud in the borehole, amount of cement required to case the hole. This all information is basically very important. I have already told you, if you have watched my previous videos, I have told you one of the important use of the caliper log is to know about the volume of the cement behind the casing. And why, where we get it from? We get it from the borehole volume. Okay, this is one of the important applications. This can ask in you in multiple choice question type. If we talk about the cement height behind the casing, that then we will get it from the temperature log. And if we talk about amount of cement, basically volume of cement behind the casing, then we will get it from the caliper log. Okay, and which is estimated with the help of borehole volume. Clear? The geometrical data from the four arm dual caliper tools such as deep meter are presented in the various formats. Okay, so there are things which are very important and you should know this. Now we are talking about the interpretation of the simple two arm caliper. In general, what we will get from the two arm caliper device? A simple caliper log records the mechanical response of the formation to drilling. Okay, a simple caliper log records the mechanical response of the formation to drilling. Okay, clear. So a hole that has the same size diameter as the bit which is drilled, it's called on gauge condition. Kya hota hai? If we are measuring the borehole diameter and that diameter of the borehole is equal to the drill bit size, that condition is known as on gauge condition. Okay, clear hai?
So a hole that has the same size diameter as the bit which is drilled it is called on gauge condition. Okay. Target of all drilling and indicates good drilling. ठीक है. What that means basically, when we are going for drilling and we want the borehole to be stable. And if it is in on gauge condition, that means the drill bit size has the same size as the diameter of the borehole. In that condition, that there is no caving is present, there is no swelling of the borehole is there. Basically, the borehole is in good condition. So that what we are saying that it's a target of all drilling and indicates good drilling. What is swelling and all these things we will see. Okay. See. So. You can see this is on gauge condition. What is happening here? The drill bit size has the same diameter as the borehole diameter. Okay, you can see this is bit size and this is the diameter of the borehole. Both are same. What will be the condition? On gauge condition. Remember this. There will be no variation in the caliper log. You can see this. No variation in that case. And now this is also condition. Now we have seen the condition where the drill bit size has the same diameter. Now what if the diameter of the borehole is larger than the bit size? What condition this will be? It will be the caved condition or washed out condition. Okay, holes with much larger diameter than the bit size, basically they we will call it caved or washed out. Okay, and when caving is present, basically you can see that bit size is fixed, borehole diameter is larger, so there is a bit size and we can see this curve here. So it represents that caving is present, the borehole diameter is larger than the bit size. Clear? Okay. And where we will get these things, this is typical of shales which are very young and unconsolidated. That means caving kahan hogi, मतलब कोई अनकंसोलिडेटेड रॉक होगा तभी केविंग चांसेस हो सकते हैं ना. ऐसा तो एक कंसोलिडेटेड है तब तो वो एकदम कॉम्पैक्ट है, तो इन दैट केस तो ऐसा होगा नहीं. तो जो एकदम यंग और अनकंसोलिडेटेड रॉक्स हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल शेल कोल्स और ऑर्गेनिक शेल, वहाँ पे हम लोग को केविंग वाली कंडीशन दिख सकती है. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ कंडीशन इज टिपिकली ऑफ शेल्स और कोल्स और ऑर्गेनिक शेल्स. नाउ I have told you two condition. First condition, the drill bit size has the same diameter as the borehole, and second condition in which the diameter of the borehole is larger than the bit size. And what if the borehole is and there is also condition when in the hole diameter is smaller than the bit size. Okay, third condition we are talking about. Calipers may show that the hole diameter is smaller than the bit size diameter. And when this will happen, if there is buildup of mud cake, then the borehole all will be then the borehole diameter will be small. Okay, can you imagine? So if a log has a smooth profile, a mud cake buildup is indicated, and this is an extremely useful indicator of permeability. Okay, only permeable beds allow the mud cake to form. So this is one of the very important application of caliper logs. So look, there is porous and permeable formation, and if there is porous and permeable formation, only then mud cake will be formed. And if mud cake will be formed, and we are getting it from the caliper log that mud cake has been formed, in that case we can indicate from the caliper log that the formation is permeable. That is why mud cake is formed. Okay, think in that way. Because if the porous and permeable formation is there, then only mud cake will form. So think in a reverse way. Our caliper logs measures that the drill bit size that the borehole size is smaller than the drill bit size. And when this is possible, if the mud cake is build up. And mud cake kab build up hota hai? Jab formation permeable hota hai. So because of the caliper log, what we are getting ultimately, that the formation is permeable. Okay, very important application of caliper log. We get about the information of permeability of the formation. So this is extremely useful indicator of the permeability. Only permeable beds allow the mud cake to form. So there is also condition of slugging. Okay, you can see that. So as I've said, in well logging, we cannot totally depend on one measurement. I've told you that if the drill bit, if the borehole borehole diameter is smaller than the borehole diameter is smaller than the bit size, what will be the condition? Mud cake will be built up. But we cannot be very sure about it. Okay, we cannot be 100% very sure about it. If that if the borehole diameter is smaller than the drill bit size, then mud cake will be built up and the formation will be permeable. We cannot go on this conclusion 100%. It can be true, but we have to confirm it from other log measurements. Okay, that is the main purpose of well logging. We cannot depend on the single log. We take the information from several logging devices, then we go to a conclusion. So in that case, if there is slugging, then also in that case the borehole diameter can be small from the bit size. Okay, you can see this condition is also possible in the condition of borehole diameter being smaller than the bit size is also possible in case of slug. Okay, and this condition is called tight spot. Okay, clear? Okay, I have already told you the condition of how the mud cake has built up. So these things are clear to you, I hope. So let's see the notes. On cause conditions, I have already told you. So iske causes kya honge? Well consolidated formation, non permeable formations. Okay, in that case, quite clear to you. And when there's a massive sandstone or calcareous shales, igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks, this can be the possible lithologies. Larger than the bit size, okay, when caving condition, formation is soluble in the drilling mud, formation is weak and it's caving. Okay, and what can be the possible things? When there is a salt formation and we are drilling with the fresh water, and other cases, what can be when there is unconsolidated formation or unconsolidated sand, gravels, brittle shale is there. Okay, these are the conditions where these things are possible. Okay, clear? And smaller than bit size, formation swell and flow into the borehole. Okay, swelling. Okay, swelling. Okay, samajh rahe ho? So formation swell and flow into the borehole. So swelling sales as a condition ho sakti hai. Dusra condition ye ho sakti hai jo mud cake build up hua hai, porous and permeable formation hai. So the development of mud cake for the porous and permeable formation. Okay, to ye do cheeze hain. Agar smaller than bit size wali cheez aa rahi hai to do conclusion nikal sakta hai. What are the important use of caliper log? The first and the most important one is it gives the information about lithological assessment. Okay, I have shown you in the table. This is the table, that is what it is. Basically, we can have some idea about the lithology. Kya ho sakta hai wahan pe? An indicator of good permeability and porosity zones due to the development of mud cake in association with the gamma ray log. Okay, clear? We can have the indication of permeability. Okay, I have already told you. And very important application also, we can measure the mud cake thickness. Okay, and how this is calculated? Whatever the diameter of the bit size minus the borehole diameter upon 2. Okay, a question based on this can be asked. It's very simple, but you should know the idea. D diameter of the drill bit minus diameter of the borehole divided by 2. In that way, you can calculate the thickness of mud cake. Okay, it's quite clear. If you have clearly seen the picture, and then measurement of borehole volume, okay, and the measurement of cement required behind the casing. Okay, basically required cement volume, I have already told you so many times. This is also calculated from the caliper log. So you don't need to remember this formula, because these formulas have some, they are not very generalized formula. It can have some errors, but you should know that if someone asks you where we are going to measure the cement volume behind the casing, then in that case you should know that we are getting it from Califer law. Okay, so all these things are there. I have already told you these are the important uses of Califer law. As I've said, mud cake thickness can be estimated from the caliper by dividing the decrease in the hole size by 2. Bit size kuch hogi, okay, and caliper log jo hame reading milega usko usse subtract kar diya, divided by 2, we get the mud cake thickness. एक और कंडीशन जैसे कि मैंने बताया था कि स्लगिंग वाली चीज, सो बोर होल्स विद द स्मॉलर डायमीटर देन द बिट साइज, जैसा कि हम लोगों ने देखा था कि मटकी कंडीशन, बट देयर कैन आल्सो बी अ सिमिलर कंडीशन वेयर द बोर होल विद अ स्मॉलर डायमीटर देन द बिट साइज बट रिक्यूज आर प्रोबेबली स्लग्ड, दैट मीन्स काइंड ऑफ वेवी सर्फेस इज देयर, रिंकल्स आर प्रेजेंट, आर प्रोबेबली स्लग्ड. ओके, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ कंडीशन देयर. And the zones of small holes with the tight spot encountered during the drilling or logging. Okay, there are some tight spots. I have shown you in this figure. Let me show you the figure again. Okay. Okay, this is what it is, tight spot. So in that case, what happens? So in that case, basically the tool gets stuck. Okay, this is what it is, the zones of small holes with the tight spots encountered during drilling or logging, the tool gets stuck. What is the cause of this tight spots? Basically it is smack tight. At these points the tool gets stuck or the bit gets stuck while pulled out of the hole. This is what is called smectite. Basically smectite, you can also call it a swelling clay. Smectite is a kind of you can say that it's a swelling clay. Basically when there is a evident mixture of smectite in the clay, we will call it swelling clay, because what smectite does, it takes water from the drilling mud, expands and breaks from the formation, and then the slugging condition is there. Basically it collapsed into the borehole. That what happens, that what it is written here is swelling clay, which takes water from the drilling mud, expands, breaks from the formation and slug or basically collapse into the hole. So the tight spot in a shale sequence caused by the hole slugging due to the swelling clays. Okay, now you have the idea of slugging. Okay, yeah, we have seen this figure, slugging, we have talked about the condition and what is the reason behind it. Basically the swelling clays, and what the swelling clays are called, these are called smectites. Okay, very important point, this can be asked. Smectite is also known as swelling clay because it takes water from the drilling mud and it expands, and then when it expands it collapses into the formation, the condition of slugging happens, and we will call it a tight spot. The drill bit get stuck here. Okay, this is all the concept behind it. Clear? Okay. And there is an example also, the Gulf Coast. Basically we will call it gumbo, which often causes the hole problems, and in that case it is because it is smectite rich. Okay, so let's move forward. सो अभी तक हम लोगों ने जितना भी डिस्कशन किया, वट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस राइट नाउ, देर वेर इट वॉज सम ऑल अबाउट द साइज ऑफ द बोरहोल. बेसिकली इट वॉज अबाउट द डायमीटर ऑफ द बोरहोल. नाउ वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द शेप ऑफ द बोरहोल, एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द क्वेश्चन हैज नॉट बीन आस्क्ड येट इन एनी ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन, बट एज यू नो new questions are always in there in the examination, so you should have the idea about this, basically the shape of the borehole. And I have already told you initially, with the help of four arm caliper device we have the idea about the shape of the borehole. With the two arm caliper device we were measuring only diameter, with the four arm caliper device we will also have the information about the shape of the borehole. that is we are going to discuss now. So the dual caliper information is generally taken from the forearm deep meter tool.
So the data from the forearm caliper enables the shape of the hole to be much better defined. So there are three main types of elliptical borehole that have been recognized. This is K-seeds, washouts and breakouts. Okay, अभी समझ में नहीं आया होगा but आ जाएगा. Let's discuss this. So what happens, a hole can be basically a borehole can be seen to be on gauge. That means the drill bit size has the same diameter as the diameter of the borehole. So hole basically a borehole can be round, it can have an oval shape. Okay, that is what is called washed out condition. I will show you a figure. And it can also be enlarged, basically किसी एक साइड से enlarged हो गया. Okay, then we will call it K-seeds. So देखो borehole shape ना किस कई तरह से define किया जा सकता है. For example on gauge condition की जैसे हम लोगों ने बात की तो round borehole. If there is K-seed, हम लोगों ने अभी K-seed का मैंने नाम लिया. इस केस में क्या होता है कि बोर किसी एक साइड से enlarged हो गया, then we will call it K-seed. Then there is a condition of washout, in basically we will have a oval shaped borehole. Then it's condition of breakout. So all things will be discussed one by one. So अभी तक हम लोगों ने क्या क्या discuss किया, what we have discussed till now. अगर if there is two arm caliper device, basically simple caliper device, there are two arms. In general what information we can get from, where the bed is permeable, where the formation is permeable or not. Okay, permeable hai to mudcake banega, mudcake hoga to borehole diameter will be smaller than the bit size, we have seen that. Impermeable hai in general to we get the on gauge condition. Okay, also we have seen the phenomena of tight spot. Okay, from this and tight spot is also, in that case also we see that because the borehole diameter will be smaller than the bit size. Okay, and all these things we have discussed so far. So all this information can also be get from the forearm dual caliper device. Dual caliper means there are four arms both in pairs. So dual caliper means there are four arms, two arms in one pair. Okay, clear. So all this information we are getting from the simple caliper device, we can also get it from the dual caliper device. Then what is the purpose of introducing four arm devices? We can have the extra information about the borehole. Okay, and this is basically related to the shape of the borehole. Let's see. So look how this is basically. Let us suppose this is a cross section. So on one pair this is 1 and 3, and on the other side, which is denoted by the green line, it is 2 and 4. So I have just trying to show you the cross section. So 1, 3 and 2, 4, these are the forearms. This is the forearm dual caliper device. You can just imagine two arms, two arms in one pair. Okay, so what is the on gauge condition? We have already discussed that the diameter of the bit will be the diameter of the hole in on gauge condition. So in that case these both arms will show the same reading. Okay, let's think that this represents zero line, basically this is the bit size line. Okay, and one arm of the device will go along this direction like this. Okay, there will be no deviation, and the other arm of the device, basically 1, 3, will show the same direction. Basically 1, 3 will show the same direction like which is showing in the green line, and 2, 4 will also show the same direction. Okay, are you getting it? There will be no deviation because in on gauge condition both arms will give the same reading. That is what I'm trying to tell you. Both arms in the dual caliper device will show the same reading. Okay, ये जो शुरू में मैं बात कर रहा था इस फिनोमिना की, ये जो यहाँ पे मैं बात कर रहा था, ये तुम देख रहे हो, इसी की मैं बात कर रहा था शुरू में, जो मैं पूछ रहा था, दिस इज द फिनोमिना. ओके, सो द कैलिपर्स हियर, द रीडिंग्स वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम 1-3 एंड द कैलिपर्स विच इज 2-4, बोथ दिस रीडिंग्स आर क्वाइट सिमिलर. दैट मीन्स दे आर शोइंग वेरी लिटिल डेविएशन, बिट साइज से इनका डेविएशन बहुत कम है. ओके, समझ में आई बात? इसी की मैं बात कर रहा था उस वक्त. और इस कंडीशन को हम क्या बोलते हैं? ऑन गॉश कंडीशन. तो ऑन गॉश कंडीशन ही ये डोनेट करता है कि जहाँ तुम्हारा बोथ रीडिंग्स वी गेट फ्रॉम द कैलिपर फेयर्स आर नियरली इक्वल टू दी बिट साइज, दे शो नो और वेरी लिटिल वेरिएशन. ओके, क्लियर? एंड द बोर होल शेप विल बी राउंड. ओके, लेट्स सी द फिगर, देन यू विल हैव अ बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. सी इन दिस फिगर, यू कैन सी द बिट साइज इज देयर, एंड बोथ दिस डॉटेड लाइन रिप्रेजेंट्स, दिस डॉटेड लाइन रिप्रेजेंट्स बेसिकली 2-4 पेयर, एंड द सिंपल लाइन रिप्रेजेंट 1-3 पेयर. सो द 1-3 पेयर इन ऑन गॉज कंडीशन, द 1-3 पेयर एंड द 2-4 पेयर बोथ शो द सेम, दे बेसिकली शो नो डेविएशन, दे बेसिकली गिव द सेम रीडिंग इन ऑन गॉज कंडीशन. क्लियर? एंड द बोरहोल शेप विल बी राउंड. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी अनदर टर्म. नाउ देयर इज अ फिनोमेना ऑफ के सिटिंग. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इन के सिटिंग? इसमें बेसिकली क्या होता है कि वन साइड ऑफ द बोर होल इट गेट इनलार्ज्ड. ओके, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस. लेट अस सपोज वी हैव अ हाईली डेविएटेड वेल. ओके, दिस ग्रीन लाइन शोज द हाईली डेविएटेड वेल. ओके, एंड वी आर पुलिंग आउट अवर ड्रिल बिट पाइप. सो वेन वी आर पुलिंग आउट अवर ड्रिल बिट पाइप, वॉट हैपन्स? बिकॉज दिस इज हाईली डेविएटेड वेल, सो बिकॉज ऑफ देयर इज ड्यू टू अपवर्ड फोर्स, द पाइप विल बी लाइक अटैच टू द अपर सर्फेस ऑफ द होल. आर यू गेटिंग इट? क्या होता है कि इन अ हाईली डेविएटेड वेल, जब हम ड्रिल पाइप को ऊपर खींचने की कोशिश करते हैं, तो वो ऊपर की जो साइड है बोरहोल का, उससे चिपक जाता है. ठीक है, इन दैट कंडीशन समटाइम्स, जब हम इन दैट कंडीशन व्हेन वी टेक द मेजरमेंट बाय द फोर आर्म डिवाइस, सो लेट अस सपोज इन दैट केस इफ यू आर टेकिंग द मेजरमेंट बाय योर फोर आर्म डिवाइस, सो व्हाट हैपेंस? वन साइड ऑफ द आर्म गिव द स्मॉल वैल्यू एंड द अदर आर्म्स गिव द लार्जर वैल्यू. सो लुक what happens, this basically our the device will be in this direction, and this arm particularly will give some small value, and the other arm like this one will give the larger value. That what happens. Okay, if we in a highly deviated well, so in that case we will see a quite deviation. Okay, so basically there will be a key like structure of the borehole. ओके, शेप ऑफ द बोरहोल बेसिकली. लेट मी शो यू फिगर, देन यू विल हैव अ क्लियर आइडिया. सी इन दैट केस द डॉट 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 रिप्रेजेंट्स, व्हाट इट रिप्रेजेंट्स, बेसिकली 2-4 पेयर, एंड द ब्लैक लाइन रिप्रेजेंट्स 1-3 पेयर. सो यू कैन सी वन आर्म इज गिविंग ए स्मॉल वैल्यू एंड अदर इज गिविंग अ लार्ज वैल्यू, एंड दिस शेप is quite in a key shape, the borehole shape is quite in a key shape. Okay, so this phenomena is known as key setting. Okay, so what you have to remember here, that in a highly deviated well, when we try to pull out the drill bit, in that case it's get little stuck to the upper surface, and in that case when the measurement is taken, we get the value, the one arm gives the smaller value, the other arm gives the larger value. One arm gives the smaller value, the other arms give the larger value, and this phenomenon is known as key setting. Okay, clear? So now let's discuss washout. So washout develop from journal drilling wear. Okay. Washout developed from general drilling wear and especially in shaly zones and dipping beds. Okay. What happens in a case of washout zone? There will be enlargement from the all sides. Okay, we have discussed the phenomena of caving. Okay, let us suppose there is an unconsolidated shale. Okay, so you can see in this figure also. So caving, phenomena of caving happens. In that case, there will be enlargement of the borehole from all sides. Okay, and in this time when we measure the forearm, in this time when we are measuring from the forearm devices, it will give the larger reading from the drill bit size in both pairs. Okay, we will get the large reading from drill bit size in both pairs. Okay, are you getting it? Both arm reading will be larger than the bit size. Okay, let me show you the figure. Okay, see, these both pairs are showing a larger size from the drill bit size. Clear hai? Okay, I have tried to explain this in as easy way possible as and try to listen very clearly. In this case, the both arms will give the larger size. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. So in general, what happens, the both calipers are larger than the drill bit size, and sometimes the one caliper being much larger than the other. Okay, we have seen in the figure. Now the other thing comes about the breakout. This breakout phenomena is quite different from all the phenomena we have discussed so far. So they have some strict like criteria where the breakout can happen. Okay, so in case of breakout, the tool must stop rotating. Suppose there is a breakout zone, the tool will not rotate in this zone. It will rotate above the zone and below the zone, but in this zone, which is a breakout zone, the tool will not rotate. This is the first condition. The second condition is, since let us suppose basically ye jo breakout hota hai na, we will observe this phenomena in case of fracture. So suppose we have a fracture in this zone. Okay, this zone represents fracture on the both sides. Okay, so if we are measuring in this zone, what happens, the one arm of the device, so let us suppose in this direction, it gives the same size as the bit size. Okay, it gains the same size of the borehole diameter at the bit size, but the other direction, this direction, this will give a change reading. Basically in this case, the borehole diameter increases from the bit size. That happens in the breakout. Okay, one side remains same. Basically one arm gives the same reading as the bit sides, and the other arm gives the reading larger than the bit sides. That is what you have to remember. Okay, so in this case, the larger caliper should exceed the hole gauge and the smaller caliper should not be less than the hole gauge. See in this figure, this is what the condition of breakout represents. The one arm showing the no deviation. Okay, the one arm is showing no deviation. Basically it is equal to the drill bit size, and other, the 2-4, denotes the increased distance, increased diameter from the drill bit size. Okay, that what happens in the case of breakout. So this is what it is, breakout condition. Okay, so these are the nodes which I have already told you where the washout will occur. It will develop from the from general drilling wear, shaly zones, and both the calipers are larger than the drill bit size. I have already told you the washout condition, and key sit condition I have already told you. We will get the asymmetric oval holes and formed by the wear against the drill string out. Okay, and I have already told you about case sets. It is observed in case of oval holes. Basically, when the our hole has a highly deviation, and where there is a sharp increase in the inclination of the borehole, this sharp increase in the inclination is known as dog legs, And I've already told you about the K-set phenomena, how it happens. Okay, we will get the both reading will be different from the drill bit size. That is what you have to remember. One is smaller, other is larger. Okay. Now, breakout condition. So already told you the tool must stop rotating. Okay. Already told you about breakout. Now there is a reason why breakouts are caused. What is the reason behind it? Basically, it is the interaction of stresses induced by the drilling and existing stress regime of the country rock. So what is the reason behind these breakouts? Okay, why this is happening? Because of the interaction of stresses induced by the drilling and existing stress of the country rock. Okay. So in this figure you can see that the breakout is happening along the minimum horizontal stress. Okay, the breakout formation during drilling in the direction of minimum horizontal stress. Okay, so इस फिगर को देख के समझने की कोशिश करो. देखो अभी दुनिया भर की चीज़ें समझने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, जितनी इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ें हैं उनके बारे में बात करते हैं. ये जो तुम्हारा ब्रेकआउट कंडीशन होता है ना, क्या होता है कि हमारा ड्रिल बिट है वो रोटेट कर रहा होता है, तो जो ड्रिल बिट है जो रोटेट कर रहा होता है उसकी वजह से स्मॉल ब्रिटल फ्रैक्चर्स क्रिएट होते हैं. ओके, बिकॉज ऑफ द रोटेटिंग ड्रिल बिट. अब ये जो स्मॉल फ्रैक्चर्स क्रिएट होते हैं ना, ये उस जगह पे फॉर्म होते हैं इफ द फॉर्मेशन हैज अनइक्वल हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेस. समझ में आया मैंने क्या कहा? ये जो फ्रैक्चर्स स्मॉल लिटिल फ्रैक्चर्स बिकॉज ऑफ द ड्रिलिंग रोटेटिंग बिट इज फॉर्म अलोंग इट इज फॉर्म इन अ प्रेफरेंशियल डायरेक्शन. ओके, इट इज फॉर्म इन अ प्रेफरेंशियल डायरेक्शन एंड दैट प्रेफरेंशियल डायरेक्शन इज प्रोवाइडेड if there is unequal horizontal stress is present in the formation. If there is unequal horizontal stress is present in the formation, that is what happen. Small brittle fractures are formed in the preferential direction, and that preferential direction is minimum horizontal stress. Okay, that preferential direction where small brittle fractures are formed is minimum horizontal stress. Okay, clear? यहाँ तक clear है चीजें? In other words, हम ये कह सकते हैं कि जो fracturing of the borehole wall is, it is localized in the direction of minimum horizontal formation stress. Okay, जो कि तुम्हें इस figure में दिख रहा है, SH minimum, ये जो SH minimum दिख रहा है ना, हाँ, ये तुम्हारा इसके along तुम्हारे small brittle fractures form होते हैं, and this fractures is the cause of the breakouts. Okay, कहने का मतलब other words में भी कह सकते हो कि breakout जो है उससे हमें ये पता चलता है कि present day पे जिस दिन हमने drilling किया उस वक्त stress field का orientation क्या है. ठीक है, उस वक्त के स्ट्रेस फील्ड का ओरिएंटेशन क्या है, ये हमें ब्रेकआउट से पता चलता है. इनको ऐसा समझो कि जो प्रीवियसली नेचुरल या नेचुरल फ्रैक्चर प्रेजेंट होंगे या जॉइंट्स प्रेजेंट होंगे उनसे ब्रेकआउट का लेना देना नहीं है. ब्रेकआउट का लेना देना है कि आज रोटेटिंग ब्रिट की वजह से जो स्मॉल फ्रैक्चर्स क्रिएट हुए हैं उनकी वजह से ब्रेकआउट फिनोमेना हुआ है. तो ब्रेकआउट फिनोमेना का लेना देना प्रेजेंट डे स्ट्रेस कंडीशन से है, ना कि प्रीवियसली जो आर्टिफिशियल या नेचुरल फ्रैक्चर प्रेजेंट रहे हैं. समझ में आई बात? तो प्रेजेंट डे जो स्ट्रेस कंडीशन होगी उसकी इंफॉर्मेशन हमें ब्रेकआउट जोन से पता चलती है. बस इतनी बात समझनी है. ओके, और एक चीज और जान लो कि जो नेचुरल फ्रैक्चर होते हैं वो दे आर मोस्ट लाइकली टू बी ओरिएंटेटेड इन द मैक्सिमम हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेस डायरेक्शन. ओके, that is means they are perpendicular to the breakout. ओके समझ में आई बात. ये जो तुम्हारा है, कहने का मतलब है ये जो तुम्हारा एस एच मिनिमम है, इसके अलॉन्ग मतलब मिनिमम हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेस के अलॉन्ग ब्रेकआउट फॉर्म हुआ, और जो नेचुरल फ्रैक्चर्स प्रेजेंट हैं वो उसके परपेंडिकुलर होते हैं. ठीक है, ये देखो ये जो एस एच मैक्सिमम है ये तुम्हारे मिनिमम हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेस के परपेंडिकुलर है. कहने का मतलब है ब्रेकआउट तुम्हारा, तुम्हें बस इतनी बात याद रखनी है कि ब्रेकआउट मिनिमम हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेस के अलॉन्ग फॉर्म होगा, और जो तुम्हारा नेचुरल फ्रैक्चर्स हैं वो मैक्सिमम हॉरिजॉन्टल स्ट्रेस के अलॉन्ग फॉर्म होते हैं, जो कि यहाँ पे दिख रहा है तुम्हें कि ये एक दूसरे के परपेंडिकुलर है. बस इतनी बात जाननी है इसमें, और कुछ नहीं है. ओके ओके, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कैलिपर लॉगिंग. आई हैव ट्राइड टू एक्सप्लेन ईच एंड एवरीथिंग. आई हैव ट्राइड टू कवर ऑल द बुक्स, ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स. इफ एनीथिंग इज स्टिल लेफ्ट यू कैन कॉमेंट, आई विल डिस्कस दैट. एंड दिस लास्ट पोर्शन विच इज़ अबाउट इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द फोर आर्म डिवाइसेस, आई थिंक दिस पार्ट विल बी लिटिल डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड. आई नो, बट आई हैव ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन इट वेरी ईजिली. स्टिल यू हैव एनी कन्फ्यूजन यू कैन कॉमेंट, वी विल डिस्कस दैट. सो मीट यू एट द नेक्स्ट वीडियो एंड वी विल डिस्कस वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट लॉगिंग, दिस इज SP log. Okay, so meet you at the next video. Thank you.